Welcome to the National Science and Math Week.
Salma,
5.4 watts.
You're right.
Giving function.
You're right. KNUST Senior High School. Congratulations on winning the contest. Welcome to the National Science and Math Quiz. Today we bring you the fifth 1A stage contest in the 2016 edition of the National Science and Math Quiz. The contest features Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School, Bolgatanga Senior High School, and Boa Amponsem Senior High School. I have here with me Bolgatanga Senior High School, represented by
Aindana Bernard, final year.
Also Emmanuel, final year.
You're welcome, gentlemen. How are you?
You're fine.
Good. So, Bolgatanga Senior High School, you've been missing for a while. Or it wasn't you that was missing. No, you were here last year.
Yeah.
Yes. But you didn't make it beyond the 1A stage of competition last year. This year, what are your plans for us?
Our plan is, may the good Lord see us through.
That's the plan.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. Thank you very much. And best wishes to you.
Okay.
Next, I have Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School, represented by
Ajo Hinoa Kranton, final year.
Felicia Lantai Anan Mills, final year.
You are very welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
And how are you?
I'm fine.
Very good. Nice. All right. So, last year, you came up against WBM Zion Senior High School at the 1A stage. You won and then went on to the quarterfinals where you lost to Achimota School. Is that accurate?
Yes.
All right. So you are a seeded school. You must have high hopes. What's the plan today?
We give our best. We go on our side.
All right. Thank you very much. Best wishes. Finally, I have here with me Boa Amponsem Senior High School, represented by
Amero Josbet, final year.
Ade Franco, being final year.
You are welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you, madam.
And how are you today?
Doing great.
Doing great. That's wonderful. Let's see what I have here. Oh, you were the ones that did not make it last year. You were missing in action. All right. But this year, you have already seen a Kumfia Meyao Senior High School and Bole Senior High School off. How was that contest?
We see we won through the grace of God.
Okay. And this time?
We believe that with God being our leader, we'll be able to come out successfully in this competition.
All right. Best wishes to you. Those are our contestants ready to go. Everybody has God on their side. All right. Before I sit down, let me acknowledge that the National Science and Maths Quiz is proudly produced by Primetime Limited and sponsored by the Ghana Education Service through the Conference of Heads of Assisted Secondary Schools and also supported by RMG Ghana Limited. My name is Dr. Elsie Efa Kaufman. I am a senior lecturer in the Department of Biomedical Engineering, University of Ghana. I'm your quiz mistress. Contestants, the contest comes to you in five rounds. The first round is a round for fundamental concepts, simple direct questions requiring simple direct answers from you. If you answer your major question correctly, 3 points. If the question is incorrectly answered, it gets passed on for the other two schools to ring for. Once a school rings and answers correctly, a bonus point. If the answer is incorrect at that stage, it fetches a penalty point. For questions that require calculations, you have 30 seconds to present an answer. If there are no calculations involved, you have 10 seconds to do so. All questions, all, are to be attempted once only. Best wishes to all three schools. I'm going to start with Bolgatanga Senior High School. Your question. What is the SI prefix for 10 raised to the power 12? Bernard.
Tetra.
That's incorrect. Which of you? Yes, Frank.
Terra.
Terra is right. Your major question. What power of 10 corresponds to the SI prefix ato? Yes, Frank.
10 to the power negative 18.
You are right. Mfantsiman Girls, how many gigahertz make 1 megahertz? Yes, Lankai.
2 gigahertz.
That's incorrect. Which of you raise your hand, Emmanuel?
3.
Oh, no. The right answer is 1/1,000. All right, Bolgatanga. How many elements are present in group 8 or 18 of the periodic table? Yes, Bernard?
6.
You're right. Boa Amponsem, what are the first and the last elements in period 3 of the periodic table? Yes, Frank?
The first is sodium and the last is argon.
You're right. Mfantsiman Girls, what is the atomic number of the first element in the first period of the D transition elements? Yes, Lankai?
58.
That's incorrect. Yes, Bernard?
21.
That's right. For the next set, you have 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Bolgatanga, a customer pays 840 Ghana cedis for an item at a discount of 20%. Find the original price. For bonus. Frank.
Ace. 1,150 Ghana cedis.
Oh no. The right answer is 1,050 Ghana cedis. An item originally listed at 2,000 Ghana cedis is sold at a discount of 15%. Find the sales price. Yes, Frank.
1,700 Ghana cedis.
You're right. At a sales, a radio originally listed at 500 Ghana cedis is sold for 350 Ghana cedis. Find the percentage discount. Yes, Lankai.
30%.
You're right. Distinguish between dicotyledonous plants and monocotyledonous plants with reference to the following. I hope you got your preamble. All right, so now Bolgatanga, type of root system. Yes, Bernard.
Dicotyledonous plants have tap root system, whereas monocotyledonous plants have fibrous root system.
Okay. With the same preamble, Boa Amponsem, arrangement of vascular bundles. Yes, Frank.
The vascular bundles in monocot is scattered, whereby that in dicot is arranged. Oh. It's not scattered, it is in rings.
I'll give you 2 out of 3. Frank, you are right. Oh, it's not scattered, but the arrangement is a regular circular or cylindrical pattern. Okay. Mfantsiman girls, with the same preamble, arrangement of leaf veins. Yes, Lankai.
Dicotyledonous plants have a net venation of leaves, whereas the monocotyledonous plants have parallel venation.
Yes. Well, Gatanga, what is the time constant of a series RC circuit containing a 10 ohm resistor and a 5 microfarad capacitor? Yes, Bernard.
0.2 seconds.
That's incorrect. For bonus, yes, Frank?
5 times 10 to the power negative 5 seconds.
You're right. Find the time constant of a series RL circuit containing a 10 ohm resistor and a 5 microhenry inductor. Frank?
5 times 10 to the power minus 5 seconds.
That's incorrect. For bonus. Yes, Bernard.
0.5 microseconds.
You're right. So 5 times 10 to the negative 7, not 5. Determine the inductance in a series RL circuit containing a 10 ohm resistor and whose time constant is equal to that of a series RC circuit containing a 10 ohm resistor and a 5 microfarad capacitor. Yes, Lankai.
5 times 10 to the power negative 4, Henry.
You're right. Bolgatanga. Methanoic acid has a pKa of 3.76. Calculate the pKb of the methanoate ion. Yes, Bernard.
10.24.
You're right. Boa Amponsem. Calculate the pH of a 0.10 mole per decimeter cube solution of methanoic acid whose pKa is 3.76. Yes, Frank?
2.38.
You're right. Mfantsiman girls, calculate the pH of 0.5 mole per decimeter cube solution of HCl. You may assume that log to the base 10 of 5 is equal to 0.70. Yes, Lankai?
3.
That's incorrect. For bonus. Frank?
1.7.
Oh. The right answer is 0.30. Find the values of X for which the expression is undefined. So I'll give you an expression. Find the values of X for which the expression is undefined. Your expression, Bolgatanga, X divided by the expression X squared plus 1. Bernard.
When x squared is equal to minus 1.
That's incorrect for bonus. I didn't ask for x squared. I asked for x. All right. There is no value of x at which this is undefined. It's always defined. All right. With the same preamble, Boa Amponsem, x divided by the expression x squared minus 1. Yes, Frank?
When x is equal to 1.
2 out of 3. There's another one. When x is negative 1, it is also undefined. Mfantsiman girls, x minus 2 all over 2 expressions multiplying in the denominator. X plus 1, x minus 3. Those are the 2 expressions multiplying the denominator. Yes, Lankai? Lankai?
The expression is undefined when x is equal to minus 1 or x is equal to 3.
You're right. Last set of questions for the round, and I'm starting with a preamble. Preamble to all schools. State the differences between the male gametes and the female gametes of humans with regard to the following. Did you get your preamble? Yes. Okay. Bolgatanga, their relative numbers. Yes, Bernard.
The male gametes are numerous, whereas the female gametes is usually 1, or there are fewer.
Yes. Boa Amponsem, their shape. Yes, Frank.
The male has the shape is like a tadpole, whereby the female has an oval shape.
I'm going to give you 2 out of 3. You need to be a little bit more elegant in your description of these shapes, huh? Okay, so the ovum is spherical. You see, it's not a two-dimensional thing when oval is okay. It's spherical, in 3 dimensions, spherical. And then the sperm is elongated. Well, it has a tail, that's why you're saying tadpole. All right. Mfantsiman girls, with the same preamble, their size. Yes, Lankai.
The size of the ovum is relatively larger than that of the sperm.
Yes. And that's the end of the first round.
The Good Life of Agriculture with RMG Ghana Limited. Experience our quality crop protection products, seeds, fertilizers, irrigation equipment, and technical expertise to increase your yield. RMG Ghana Limited. Agriculture on a sustainable basis.
At the end of the first round, Bolgatanga Senior High School has 13 points. Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School has 15 points. Boa Amponsem Senior High School has 18 points. I would like to encourage all schools to work even harder. Round 2. This is a round known as the speed race. Questions in this round are thrown to all three schools at the same time. The first school to ring and answer correctly earns 3 points. If a school gets it correctly on the second attempt, 2 points. On the third attempt, 1 point. In order to answer a question, a school will have to ring. May I hear your bell, Bolgatanga Senior High School? Thank you. Yours, Mfantsiman Girls. Thank you. And yours, Boa Amponsem. Thank you. When you ring, the answer must be ready. For questions that require calculation, you'll have a maximum of 30 seconds to present an answer. If there are no calculations involved, your maximum amount of time is 10 seconds. Best wishes to all three schools. First question. Find the measures of two supplementary angles if one measure is thrice the other. Yes, Frank?
One angle is 50 degrees and the other is... One angle is 30 degrees and the other is 150 degrees.
Yes, Lankai?
45 degrees and 135 degrees.
You're right. Determine whether the lines with equations y is equal to 2x plus 3 and y is equal to negative 2x plus 3 are parallel. Frank?
They are perpendicular.
That's incorrect. So I continue. Are parallel, perpendicular, or neither? Yes, Lankai?
They are neither of them.
Yes. What name is given to the rapid growth of populations of algae in either freshwater or saltwater environments? Bernard?
Algal bloom. Algal bloom.
Bloom. Okay. What name is given to an increase in the growth of algae due to the buildup of nutrients in a lake? Yes, Bernard?
Eutrophication.
Yes. What is the important function of the operculum in mosses? Yes, Frank?
It provides protection to the capsule and the spores in the capsule.
Yes. State fully the acid functional group of phenol. Yes, which of you? Lankai?
Phenol methanoic acid.
No. Yes, Frank?
Phenol alkanoic acid.
Ah, no. Yes, Bernard.
Benzoic acid.
Are we talking about the same question? The functional group is an OH group bonded to an aromatic nucleus. That's a functional group. All right. How many carbons are present in a molecule of 2-methyl-icosane? Yes. Which of you, Lankai?
21 carbons.
You're right. What is the name of a long-chain saturated hydrocarbon with 11 carbons in a chain? Yes, Emmanuel?
Undecane.
Undecane. What is the atomic number of tritium? Bernard?
One.
Yes. What is the weight of a floating object which displaces 0.5 meter cubed of water? Bernard?
500 kilograms.
That's incorrect. Yes, Frank?
5,000 newtons.
You're right. The working substance of a heat engine absorbs 10 kilojoules of thermal energy from a hot reservoir and rejects 8 kilojoules to a cold reservoir in one cycle. What is the work done by the engine? Yes, Frank.
Zero.
No. Yes, Lankai.
40.
No. Yes, Emmanuel.
2 joules.
Oh. The right answer is 2 kilojoules. And that's the end of the second round. At the end of the second round, Boa Amponsem Senior High School has 23 points. Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School has 24 points. Bolgatanga Senior High School has 25 points. Round 3. This round has our problem of the day. The problem of the day is a single question to all three schools. From the time I ask you to begin, you have 3 minutes to present a single answer from your school. The problem of the day is worth 10 points. Let's turn over our sheets and read the problem of the day together. Problem of the day. The solar constant, the mean intensity on the Earth's surface of radiation from the sun, is 1,000 watts per meter squared. A solar power installation comprises 5 solar panels with a conversion efficiency of 20% installed in such a manner that each panel, measuring 2 meters long and 1 meter wide, can receive direct sunlight. A. Calculate the maximum electrical power per unit area each panel can deliver. B. Calculate the maximum power the 5-panel insulation can provide. And C. Estimate the maximum energy the insulation can provide in 2 hours of maximum sunshine. Contestants, this is your problem of the day. You may now begin. Writing and present your answers. Contestants, please pick up your notepads and present your answers on the boards. Thank you. The contestants have presented their answers. Before we award the marks, let's look at the suggested solution from our consultants. This is a problem in physics. So we have been given the solar constant, and we know it's 1,000 watts per meter squared. And then we know that we have an installation of solar panels. There are five of them. We've been given the area of each panel to be 1 meter long and 1 meter wide. We know each of them is operating at an efficiency of 20%. All right, and we need to answer some questions about this. The first one is that we need to find out the electrical power per unit area that each panel can deliver. All right, so we have been given the maximum power density. So this is equal, in order to obtain that, what you do is you take the solar constant and you multiply that by the efficiency. The efficiency is 20% or 0.2, right? And then the solar constant is 1,000. So if you take 1,000 and multiply that by 0.2, you get the maximum power density, and that is 200 watt per meter squared. For doing this calculation, 3 points. The second question that we have to answer is to find the maximum power the five panel installation can provide. From our first calculation, we can find out what each panel can provide, then multiply by 5 to get 45. All right? So each panel has an area of 2 meters squared because we know the dimensions. So each panel can give 400 watts. How did we get that? You know, we have 200, and then we have multiplied by 200 watts per meter squared, multiplied by 2 meters squared, which is the area, to give 400 watts for each. To get to this calculation, 2 points. So if you want to know how much the five can give you, you take this 400 watts and multiply by 5 to give 2,000 watts, another 2 points. Finally, we are to estimate the maximum energy the installation can provide in 2 hours of maximum sunshine. All right, so we need to, since we are working in SI units, we need to convert this time. We need to convert this time to seconds. So we'll get 7,200 seconds, and now the amount that we are providing from the five is 2,000 watts. So we multiply 2,000 watts by 7,200 seconds to get 14,400 kilojoule. 3 points for this, giving a total of 10 points. All right, contestants. Boa Amponsem, honestly, you couldn't do much about this problem. You were doing the wrong calculation in the right sections, or the wrong sections with right calculation. So the first part, you were supposed to get the maximum power density. And the maximum power density, as we talked about, is 200 watts per meter squared. Wrong calculation there. I can't give that to you. All right. The second part is to get the power each panel can provide, right? And then multiply by 5 to get the total. Again, you didn't make much progress with that. But the third part, you realize that you needed to do energy. You needed to get the energy, and so you took the power and multiplied by time. That's the right calculation, but because of all the things that had gone wrongly, so I'm giving you 1 point for that formula. So that leaves you with 1 out of 10. Mfantsiman girls, your first calculation was not right for A. It was not right. That was not the calculation that was called for. Right? But at least you did something. You were trying to, you multiplied by the 0.2, 20 over 100 for efficiency. So you are trying to do something with the efficiency. I'll give you 1 point for attempting that part. Then you were able to do the second part. Right? You wound up with 400 watts multiplied by 5 to get 2,000. Or am I seeing wrongly? Okay, so you have 4 points for that. And then since I gave a mark for the right formula for the energy, power multiplied by time, I'll add one to that because you also have the right formula. That gives you 6 out of 10. Bolgatanga, very similar to the Mfantsiman girls. Wrong calculation for the first part, but then you at least were doing some calculations around efficiency, 1 point. Then you got the second part right, 4 points. The third part, you have the formula power times time, so I'll add one to it, giving you 6 out of 10. That's the end of the problem of the day and the end of round three. You may pick up your notepads. Round four. In this round, I'm going to present each school with statements. When you receive your statement, please consider the statement carefully and let me know whether it's true or false. If you're right, 2 points. If you're incorrect, you lose a precious point. You may choose not to respond, in which case the statement becomes available to the other two schools. A school may ring and answer. If the answer is right, 2 4-point points. If the answer is incorrect, it fetches that penalty point. Best wishes to all three schools. I'm starting with you, Boa Amponsem, your statement. Mitochondria are green because of the chlorophyll they contain. Frank.
It's false.
You're right. And fancy man girls. Energy-rich compounds from the cytosol are oxidized in the chlorophyll. Yes, Lankai.
False.
You're right. The outermost region of the mitochondrion folds to form the cristae. Yes, Bernard.
False.
You're right. Boa Amponsem, a parallelogram with a right angle is a rectangle. Yes, Frank.
It's false.
Oh no, that's a true statement. Mfantsiman girls, a rectangle is a parallelogram. Yes, Lankai.
True.
Yes. A rectangle is a square. Bernard.
False.
Yes. Boa Amponsem, the limiting thermal efficiency of a heat engine depends on the temperatures of the hot and cold thermal reservoirs between which it operates. Yes, Frank?
It's true.
Yes. Mfantsiman girls, a real heat engine cannot convert all the thermal energy it receives into work. Yes, Lankai?
True.
Yes. Because adiabatic processes occur without heat exchange, a heat engine cannot operate on a cycle that includes an adiabatic process. Bernard.
False.
You're right. Boa Amponsem, both CO2 and SO2 molecules have the same shape. Frank.
It's false.
You're right. CH4 and NH3 have different shapes. This is a result of the difference in the hybridization of the bonding orbitals of carbon and nitrogen. Yes, Lankai?
False.
You're right. In cyclohexane, all the 6 carbons are in the same plane. Bernard?
It's true.
Oh, no. That's a false statement. Boa Amponsem, Sleeping sickness, one of the most dreaded diseases in Africa, is caused by a flagellate. Yes, Frank?
It's false.
Ooh, it's a true statement. Mfantsiman girls, the vector for sleeping sickness is a type of worm. Lankai?
It's false.
Yes. The vector for sleeping sickness can infect only humans, but not any other mammal. Yes, Bernard?
False.
Yes. Amponsem, 0.49 is an exact square. Yes, Frank?
It's true.
Yes. (36/15) is an exact square. Yes, Lankai?
It's false.
Yes. 0.9 is not an exact square. Yes, Bernard?
It's true.
Yes. The resistance of a circuit containing two identical resistors in parallel equals twice the resistance of one of the resistors. Frank?
It's false.
You're right. The current in a circuit containing two identical resistors in series equals twice the current in one of the resistors. Lankai?
It's false.
You're right. The resistance of a circuit containing two identical resistors in series equals twice the resistance of one of the resistors. Bernard?
False.
Oh no. Amponsem, the electron affinity in kilojoule per mole of sulfur is larger than that of oxygen. Frank?
It's false.
Oh. It's a true statement. You are close. Sulfur is negative 200, oxygen is negative 141. Whilst beryllium and magnesium have positive values of electron affinity, lithium and sodium have negative values. Yes, Lankai?
It's true.
Yes. Last statement. The more negative the value of the electron affinity for an element, the more stable the anion formed. Emmanuel?
It's true.
Yes. That's the end of the fourth round. At the end of the fourth round, Boa Amponsem Senior High School has 31 points. Bolgatanga Senior High School has 41 points. Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School has 46 points. Finish hard, contestants. Round 5. In this round, I'm going to be reading out clues. Your objective is to solve the riddle. If you solve the riddle on the first clue, 5 points. On the second clue, 4 points. On the third or any clue thereafter, 3 points. In order to solve a riddle, you need to draw my attention. You do that by ringing your bell. May I hear your bell, Bolgatanga? Thank you. Yours, Mfantsiman girls. Thank you. And yours, Boa Amponsem. Thank you. When you ring, the answer must be ready. There are 4 riddles. First one. I am a 3-digit number between 300 and 400. The sum of my digits is 15. All my digits are prime numbers. My digits are consecutive odd numbers. Who first? Mfantsiman girls, go ahead.
357. 357.
You are right. That was the fourth clue, 3 points. Next riddle. I am an organic compound. My molecules have only carbon and hydrogen atoms. My shape can be used to illustrate the perfect tetrahedral shape. Yes, Bernard?
Benzene.
Oh. Yes, Frank?
Methane.
You're right. That was a third clue, 3 points. Next riddle. I am a type of magnetic material. I am a linear material. That is, my magnetization varies linearly with magnetic field. I have negative susceptibility. I am repelled by the poles. Go ahead, Lankai.
Ferromagnetic materials.
No. Yes, Frank.
Diamagnetic material.
You are right. I was reading the fifth and final clue, 3 points. Last riddle. I am a material of natural or synthetic origin. I may be applied as a solid or liquid. I am applied to soils or to plant tissues, usually leaves, to supply one or more plant nutrients essential to the growth. Yes, Lankai?
A fertilizer.
You are right. That was the third clue, 3 points, and that's the end of the fifth round. At the end of the contest, here are the final scores. Boa Amponsem Senior High School has 37 points. Bolgatanga Senior High School has 41 points. Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School has 52 points. Boa Amponsem Senior High School, thank you for being here. You did well. Unfortunately, we must say goodbye. All the best to you. Bolgatanga Senior High School, thank you for being here and for giving us such a good contest. All the best. Mfantsiman Girls Senior High School, congratulations on winning the contest. Incidentally, you are the first seeded school so far. That has made it to our quarterfinals. Well done. I look forward to seeing you again. All the best. Viewers, thank you for joining us for this exciting contest. We are not yet done. Next time, we'll bring you the sixth 1A stage contest, which will feature Kumasi Academy, Mawuli School, and Agri Memorial Senior High School. The National Science and Math Quiz is proudly produced by Primetime Limited and sponsored by the Ghana Education Service through the Conference of Heads of Assisted Secondary Schools. We are also supported by RMG Ghana Limited. Thank you for joining us and see you next time. Bye.